Hey guys, Sarah from Sarah Smith Strength here today, and I want to talk about the three best action steps you can take if you're leaking. So many women experience leaking when they sneeze, when they cough, when they jump, when they're exercising, maybe when you're washing the dishes or suddenly hear some water, and tend to ignore it or just think, oh, this is just part of life because I had a baby. Now, not everyone that experiences this has had a baby. And this is not an automatic response to having children. In fact, many people have children, they don't have this issue. And again, like I said, some people have this problem and they never had children. This is about function. It's about function of the body. And here is the thing that you really need to understand. If you are leaking, that means that your pelvic floor isn't functioning optimally and you're not able to manage pressure. What does that mean? It means that your body is going to become injured or have other, or sustain other kinds of issues and problems that cause things like chronic pain, maybe even the need for surgery and whatnot, if you don't address it. So it's not something you just want to ignore. It's actually your body's very kind way of being like, psst, hey, something's not right, okay? And while it can be embarrassing and while, you know, you can just put a pad in and just kind of ignore it, steer clear of certain kinds of exercises, be like, mom doesn't do that anymore. The best thing to do is to take action and stop the problem, okay? Does it mean you'll never ever leak again or laugh so hard that you pee your pants? Not necessarily, but is it going to most likely, I mean, it is possible for you to eliminate this problem almost 100% if you do a few things, okay? So what is it that you're gonna do? Well, one of the first things that you need to do is learn how to manage pressure. And managing pressure is all about the breath. So when you're sneezing or you're coughing or you're exercising, you're moving something, maybe it's your body, maybe it's something else that's heavy, if you leak, it's because your body just isn't capable of managing pressure. Now you may have had this issue before you had kids, but the physiological changes that happen to your body with respect to how it's shaped and how the ligaments inside your pelvis and abdominal cavity function change after baby. Everything kind of stretches out a little bit, shifts around in the body, moves, it's different, hormones are different. So now it's an issue. But that doesn't mean that you weren't struggling with this before, it's just birth was kind of the straw that broke the needle, what is it? The straw that broke the camel's back. Okay, stay away from the metaphors. So managing pressure is all about the breath. You need to be breathing with your diaphragm, okay? Singers, people that are in the theater, anyone that has to use their voices a lot, like are familiar with this. Breathing with the diaphragm means that you move this beautiful muscle here right at the base of your rib cage up and down all day long as you breathe, okay? Many of us don't do that. This is stuck. For some of you, you might put your hands here and it actually might even be a little tender. You might get some pain in the middle of your back too because of this stickiness. So if you have a difficult time keeping your mouth shut, breathing through your nose, and having a 360 degree expansion of your ribs and relaxation of the belly when you breathe, take a few minutes after the video and see, like, can I do that? Then that could be a huge part of your problem. Your breathing mechanics are messed up. Your core stability, okay, like when everyone's talking about like strong core and all that jazz, your ability to have a strong core, a strong torso, and a pelvic floor that goes and stops you from leaking urine out of your bladder when you have some kind of sudden change in your environment is all about the breath. So practicing your breath alone, many women have taken my course, it's a free breathing course, link in my bio. Many women have taken the course and that alone was enough for them, okay? So breathing is huge because it's how we manage pressure and it has to be automatic. You don't have time, maybe with a cough, but generally something that just makes you laugh or sneeze, or if you go to the gym, you know, and there's a workout that's requiring you to do certain things that you feel like you can do, you technically have the mobility and the strength and you're cleared for that kind of exercise, but it's just the leaking getting in the way, then you have to look at your body and be like, okay, I need to automate my ability to create enough support from my bladder so that I don't leak. And that comes with the breath. It also comes with number two. So number one's the breath. And again, free course, link in my bio. It's gonna get you so much information about this. It's better than Kegels, which is what I call the course. this will change everything. If you know, a lot of women, they're like, oh, I leak, I need to just hold my vagina in tight. No, you don't. That's not the solution, okay? Yes, Kegels can be used in certain scenarios briefly, sure, if you're partnering them with your breath practice, but breathing is king, okay? Queen, whatever. Okay, so breathing, and then number two is alignment. Your breath and your ability to use the muscles, you know, the muscles in your pelvis, like your pelvic girdle, your hips, down the bottom is muscles. Those are your pelvic floor muscles, okay? And there's ligaments, there's a whole network of tissue in there that's helping everything stay where it needs to be, expand when it needs to, relax, move around, shift, all that jazz. You actually want some mobility and movement in your pelvis. And the pelvic floor and the various ligaments of the pelvis help you with that. Now, let me tell you something. They work way, way better when you have what we call neutral alignment. Not good posture. Good posture a lot of times is this. People are like, oh, I'm standing up straight. But neutral alignment, where your skeleton is stacked, I mean your skull is stacked over your skeleton, so that the diaphragm is directly over the pelvis, and the pelvis isn't tilted too far front or tucked under. There's money falling out of my pocket. Okay? So alignment is another piece of that. And that takes time and it takes practice. I have a course called Connect Your Core and Pelvic Floor that teaches you all about alignment and gives you the kinds of movement, the strength movement and exercises that you can do in exercise, in your workouts to try and retrain your body what that neutral alignment looks like. It takes time. Let me tell you, when I first had pelvic floor issues in 2015, this is what it looked like. Rounded shoulder, and then I think I had like rounded shoulders and anterior tilt. So my pelvis is tilted forward, my shoulders are rounded. I've had to do a ton of work to come back to neutral, and as I have, the functionality of everything inside improved dramatically, okay? And then the last thing is that while you're working on your breath and you're working on alignment and posture, is that you need to tend to the ligaments and the tissues in the pelvis, okay? In your pelvis and then also in your abdomen. Okay, so this whole area, there's a lot going on. If you take my breathing course, I have this really cool video that shows you everything that's in there. You've got your intestines, your liver, your stomach, your uterus, your bladder, your rectum, like kidneys. I mean, everything is jam-packed in there, all in this fluid, and they don't have much room. Okay, and then if you have, you're growing a baby, like how much more compact is everything in there? Okay. Because everything is compact, everything has a very important job. And in that really tight area, we need a lot of movement. Now, breathing with the diaphragm actually helps to move that. Every time you take an inhale, the diaphragm pushes down on those organs and kind of compresses them. And then when you exhale, if your diaphragm is functioning well, it moves up and now those organs get space. So they get massaged all day long every day. And everything, like I said, your intestines, your pelvic organs, they're all being moved around. There's also a ton of lymph, which is the fluid that the body uses to detox. It's this liquid detox system, okay? Lymph and tons of blood flow in there. But things get stuck, they get stagnant. And like I said, after baby, a lot of times ligaments get stretched and they don't function the same way. They're not as supple and responsive. And so one of the key things that we need to do is to address the musculature and the tissue of the pelvis. And you can do this two ways, and I would really, really recommend that you do both, not just one, okay? One thing is to make sure that you go and you see a pelvic floor physical therapist. You're not gonna get optimal recruitment, and what I mean by that is you're not gonna get your pelvic floor to do its job really well if you have some tight muscles that are we don't have access to. So if you're walking around with a pelvic floor that's kind of like a bicep that's like partly flexed, you're not gonna be able to get it to do its job to recruit really well to support you when you're like, achoo, right? So you need it to be able to move through its full range of motion. That's the case in the pelvic floor. So a pelvic floor physical therapist can go in, they can manually feel around inside, right? They go in the vaginal canal. Sometimes they go in the rectum if they need to, but generally they go in there and they move their fingers around and they feel your muscles and they help you understand, are you holding things too tight? If things are too tight, you can also be leaking too. Leaking is not just about a pelvic floor that is weak. Leaking is about a pelvic floor that's not doing its job. So some women have pelvic floors that are too tight, and so there's no shock absorption, and they're just holding the bladder in. The bladder doesn't empty properly, so there's urine sticking around. Like, there's a lot of reasons for that. So a pelvic floor that is being held too tight is going to be a problem. And then a pelvic floor that cannot be accessed to recruit and support the bladder so it doesn't spill out some urine when something really funny happens, then that's an issue too. A pelvic floor physical therapist will help that. They do the internal work and they help make you aware of what's going on, okay? And in addition to them, I really would like to see more and more women go and seek out abdominal pelvic massage. Abdominal pelvic massage used to be under the umbrella of Arvigo, which is like Mayan abdominal therapy. Now they're called the Abdominal Therapy Collective. So go to their website, check it out, find a practitioner near you. And what they do is they teach you how to self-massage the abdomen and the pelvis, pelvic area, right? So like right down here around your pelvic bone and then your abdominal area. And it is a game changer, okay? Why is it a game changer? Because when you partner it with your breath, which you have to do, breath is king. If you do nothing else in this video, go take my free breathing course and practice the breath. You need breath because breath is how we oxygenate all the tissues and improve blood flow and, again, oxygen access to the tissues so that the tissues stay healthy. If you use the breath and you're manually moving things around in the way that, you know, is best for the tissues and their ligaments and everything, get some movement, get some mobility, then you're going to breathe life into these ligaments. And the better all of the different ligaments that are in your pelvis are functioning and better able to support your pelvis and your pelvic organs, then the less likely it is you're going to have these kinds of issues. Everybody's just going to be like so much more alert, so much more healthy, so much more ready to do their job because you're giving them what they need. You're giving them the nourishment and the movement and the mobility that they need. Just in the same way that we need to make sure that, you know, we move our shoulders through their full range of motion to maintain mobility, in the same way that many of us who like to exercise go and get massage, right? We're like, oh yeah, this is a persistent problem over here. Or maybe you get chiropractic treatment to make sure you open up neurological channels, make sure that blood flow, lymph is flowing, all of the tissues are getting what they need. They're dumping the toxins, but they're also getting nourished with blood and oxygen. The same thing has to happen in the pelvis. So just to recap, you're leaking. Don't just automatically think that you have to Kegel and don't ignore it either. This means that what is going on in your pelvis, in your abdomen, it's not good. It's not right now. Is it fixable? Totally. You're not broken. You're not damaged. This isn't just a mom problem, but you do have to take action because things like chronic back pain, foot pain, knee replacements, shoulder issues, leaking, prolapse, like these are all of the different conditions that can be related to what you have going on. It just started out as just a little bit of peeing, right? And totally snowball into something bigger. So yes, so take the breathing course, work on your alignment. Again, you can take, I have two courses, Better Than Kegels. Just go to link in my bio and get breathing course, or you can go to tinyurl.com/betterthankegels. Free digital course. I'm very proud of it. Super high quality, lots of great images, lots of great information. People rave about it, okay? And then I have another course called Connect Your Core and Pelvic Floor, and that will teach you the alignment and the posture thing. Because the movement and breathing piece is really important. You have to move your body, and if you're afraid to move, you're just not going to get healing. But then you're going to go and you're going to get that internal work with the pelvic floor physical therapist. You don't have to go a lot. Just go and have them evaluate you. If you love the person and they have great recommendations, you can keep seeing them. But it's going to be worth like the $100, give or take, to go and see someone to find out what the heck is going on, because your body and the function of your body is important. And let me tell you, when your body ain't working, you lose confidence, you don't feel confident, and you end up sitting on the bench. And that is no bueno. So pelvic floor physical therapist, and then again, finding somebody that can teach you that abdominal pelvic massage piece will be a game changer too, because again, you go once, you learn what's going on, you learn how to do it, and then you can do it to yourself. And it's very empowering, it's very educational, you'll find out so much about your body and you will not regret it, I'm telling you, okay? So yeah, so if you're like, this is too much, where do I start? Take the breathing course. Start with the breathing course, that's it. Own your breath, because the breath and the understanding of alignment is gonna make what you get out of pelvic floor physical therapy and the abdominal massage that much richer. They're not going to have to teach you the breath because you're going to already know it, and they are going to talk about it. So be in the know, take the breathing course, link in my bio, tell your friends, have a girlfriend take it with you so that you can practice your breath together and go from there. If you forget what to do next or you're like, I'm not sure, you can email me through the course. There's ways to contact me, or you can DM me here. Okay, bye.